Hello my dear students, welcome back to chemistry class beta. So in the last class we have seen about the properties of ionic compounds like physical nature and melting point, boiling point and solubility, and one more is nothing but conduction of electricity. Okay, now the topics are very important. Once again try to make revision beta. Okay, now good. So in this part 15th video class, from the metals and non-metals topic, I'm going to discuss the topic that is nothing but the occurrence of metals, and one more very important topic is extraction of metals. Okay, no? Good. So let me explain first of all about the occurrence of metals. Metals kaise occur ho sakte, metals kaise found ho sakte, that is the meaning. Okay, good. So most of the metals and their compounds, they goes to be available, they goes to be found from what? On the earth crust. That one we know very well. That means, so earth crust is the major source of, earth crust is the major source of metals. So most of the metals and their minerals and their ores, all they are, we are getting from the what? Nana? Earth crust. That's why we have to say that earth crust is the major source of metals. And also one more source you can consider, that is nothing but seawater. Seawater means it contains number of soluble salts, number of soluble impurities we can find from the seawater. Yes or no? But the most common compound from seawater is nothing but what beta? NaCl. Actually in seawater so many soluble salts are there, but one of the best compound is nothing but NaCl. That is nothing but, we have to say that rock salt, and also we can say that common salt. From that rock salt or common salt we can extract the metal, that is nothing but the sodium metal. Okay na? So occurrence of metals ke bare mein do point perfectly remember kijiye beta. Okay, so the major source is nothing but earth crust, and one more source is nothing but seawater. From the seawater we can find so many soluble impurities or so many soluble salts. Okay beta, good. Next one is nothing but extraction of metals. From this extraction of metals, and in today's class, okay, in that topic I want to discuss about the only term, okay now, the terms which are involved in extraction of metals topic, nothing but metallurgy topic. Nana, so which terms we have to be mainly focus, wo char points apna mind mein perfectly meaning rehna beta. If you don't know the meaning of that four words, you won't read any purification, you won't read any extraction and use nana. So try to be focus on first of all four words. What are the four words? One is nothing but metallurgy, and one more is nothing but minerals, and one more is nothing but ores, and one more is nothing but gang, or we can say gang as you wish. Okay, so number one is metallurgy, number two is mineral, our next one is nothing but ore, and we can say ores, our next one is nothing but gang. A four words ka definition pehle apna mind mein fix rehna padega. You should be very familiar, okay na, about their definitions and meanings and some of the examples. Let me consider, first of all I am going to start with metallurgy. Sir, what is mean by metallurgy? Just aapko to yahan par khali introduction hai beta in our, okay na, 10th class, but actually in first PC, I mean second PC, we have a particular chapter. The chapter name is called metallurgy. Means in that chapter we have to do the extraction of metals, I mean separation of metals, we have to be do from their respective minerals and ores. Okay, so metallurgy ka meaning perfectly meaning main yahan par batana chahta. So first of all I am going to be consider the minerals, and also we can consider the ores. The minerals and ores which are available from the earth crust, first of all we have to be select now. So they undergo the process purification, I mean concentration, followed by from that minerals and ores we have to be separate the metal. Such metal separation karne ke baad we have to be purify the metal. So such procedure is known as, that is nothing but we have to be say that extraction, and also we can say that isolation. What we can say beta? Isolation. So extraction and isolation of metals from their respective minerals and ores. Such procedure is known as what beta? Metallurgy. और एक बार फोकस कीजिए. सो मेटलर्जी इज नथिंग बट वन टाइप ऑफ साइंटिफिक एंड वन टाइप ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल प्रोसेस. इन दैट प्रोसेस वी हैव टू बी डू दैट एक्सट्रैक्शन एंड सेपरेशन ऑफ मेटल्स टेक प्लेस फ्रॉम देयर रेस्पेक्टिव मिनरल्स एंड ओर्स. सच मेकानिज्म इज नोन एज मेटलर्जी. समझे? एक्सट्रैक्शन एंड आइसोलेशन इस दो वर्ड का मीनिंग इन आवर लैंग्वेज सिंपली वी कैन से दैट इज नथिंग बट सेपरेशन एंड प्यूरिफिकेशन. ओके ना? गुड. सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्शन एंड आइसोलेशन ऑफ मेटल्स फ्रॉम देयर मिनरल्स एंड ओर्स सच मैकेनिज्म इज नोन एज व्हाट बेटा मेटलर्जी. आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू वन एग्जांपल. सो एग्जांपल फॉर मेटलर्जी कैसे दे तुम बोलो तो यहां पर देखिए परफेक्टली बेटा. फर्स्ट सपोज द मिनरल इज नथिंग बट बॉक्साइट. व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ मिनरल? बॉक्साइट. सो फ्रॉम दैट बॉक्साइट मिनरल after purification, I mean after separation, after what na na, isolation, we will get the metal. The metal is nothing but aluminium. So Al metal that can be separated, that can be extracted from the mineral is nothing but bauxite. Again the procedure is known as what beta? Metallurgy. So metallurgy ka definition aapko pata lag gaya. Yes or no? Kuch nahi. Separation of and separation and purification of metals. And also we can say that extraction and isolation of metals from their respective minerals, and also we can say that from their respective ores. Such procedure is known as metallurgy. Next, go for another definition. That is nothing but second one. We have to be focused a lot on this definition. That is nothing but what beta? Minerals. Sir, what is mean by minerals? Or we can say what is mean by mineral? No problem. Okay, listen carefully. So minerals are nothing but the elements, and also we can say that minerals are nothing but the compounds, and also we can say that minerals are nothing but the substances or components which are available from the which occurs or which are found which occurs naturally which occurs naturally in the earth crust which occurs naturally in the earth crust. One second. So the elements or compounds which occurs naturally in the earth crust which are found naturally from the earth crust, such elements and compounds we have to be say that they are nothing but the minerals. Yes, I'm going to give you one example. First, suppose I'm going to write here bauxite. Bauxite. Samajh rahe na? And what is the formula of bauxite? Bauxite formula is nothing but Al2O3 dot 2 moles of H2O. Means along with Al2O3, along with alumina, there will be presence of 2 moles of H2O molecules. So this is the formula of bauxite. It is the compound. It goes to be occur naturally from the earth crust. It goes to be found naturally from the earth crust. That's why I am saying that bauxite is nothing but an example of mineral. One more thing. Next one, okay, here I am going to write another name. That is nothing but cryolite. Try to be focused on this also. Cryolite. Sir, what is mean by cryolite? Iska formula kya ho sakta? The formula of cryolite is nothing but Na3AlF6. Of course, you don't need to remember the formulas, but for understanding point of view, I am saying beta. Okay, आपने को formula कोई भी नहीं पूछता, just to try to remember the example को remember कीजिए. Good. So one is bauxite and one more is nothing but cryolite. Formula of cryolite Na3AlF6. From this bauxite, it is a mineral. From this mineral, we can separate aluminium metal. From this cryolite, here also Al is there. Again, from this mineral, we can separate the Al. So we have to say that bauxite and cryolite, both are nothing but the minerals of Al. Minerals of what beta? Aluminium. Means from these two minerals, on the process of metallurgy, we can separate the aluminium metal. Okay, na? And bauxite and cryolite. Both are nothing but the compounds. They are going to be found naturally from the earth crust. That's why they are saying that they are nothing but the minerals. okay na? Good. So next I am going to say that, sir, what is mean by ores? Ores, they are going to be, ores are nothing but the minerals beta, okay na? But little bit difference will be there. Specific definition we have to be give to that ores definition as compared to the mineral. Mineral ko apan common definition de sakte, the compounds which are naturally found from the earth crust, they are nothing but the minerals. And these two examples for aluminium metal, okay na beta? But ore ka definition thoda sa change ho sakta, and definition of ore that must to be specific for the specific metal. Yes, I will tell you. So the definition of, okay na, what beta? Ores. Listen carefully. Yes, ore is nothing but a mineral. Of course, ore ko bhi apan kya bol sakte, we can say that it is also a mineral. But which type of mineral? The mineral which is most suitable. The mineral which is most suitable for what? I will tell you, listen carefully. So first, suppose mineral undergo what beta? Extraction. And also we can say that isolation. After extraction and isolation of a particular mineral which is most suitable. So why I am saying here most suitable? Because of the reason is, minerals upon extraction and isolation, definitely they are going to be produced the metal. But here I am going to write that a particular word, we have to say that this is nothing but a particular metal, a particular metal, and that metal should be in good yield, nothing but profit bhi bahut acha rehna padega. Means a particular metal we are getting on a large scale, means commercial point of view is karna padega. Yes, we are getting a particular metal on a large scale with good, okay na, yield, and also we can say that with profitable yield. Yes, so the mineral which is most suitable for the extraction, for the isolation, for the separation of a particular metal on a large yield. मिनरल को यूज करके अपन यहाँ पर मेटल को क्या कर रहे हैं? सेपरेट कर रहे हैं. वी आर सेपरेटिंग ए पर्टिकुलर मेटल, एंड दैट मेटल शुड बी इन गुड ईल्ड, दैट मेटल शुड बी विद प्रॉफिटेबल ईल्ड. सच सेलेक्टिव एंड मोस्ट सुटेबल मिनरल्स आर नोन एज ओर्स. वंस अगेन, सो द मिनरल विच इज मोस्ट सुटेबल, ओके, फॉर द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ ए पर्टिकुलर मेटल ऑन ए लार्ज स्केल. For the extraction of a particular metal on a what na with a profitable yield, such particular and suitable mineral is known as ore. Definition pata lagaya? Yes, I have an example that you try to remember. What are the minerals of aluminium? One is bauxite, one more is nothing but cryolite. I am saying that bauxite and cryolite are the minerals of Al, but both are not the ores of Al. Aur ek bar condition. Bauxite and cryolite both are nothing but the minerals of aluminium, but I am saying that only bauxite is the ore of aluminium. Difference pata laga? Aur ek baar bolta hu, bauxite and cryolite both are nothing but the minerals of aluminium, but I am saying that only bauxite is the ore of Al. That means bauxite is a suitable mineral. It is most suitable. Bauxite is most suitable to give the particular metal, that is nothing but aluminium. Do bhi compounds se apan aluminium ko separate kar sakte, but in that two which is most suitable to give Al, bauxite is most suitable for the separation of Al. Such most suitable mineral is called ore. I hope you understand. So here answer is nothing but bauxite is the ore of, bauxite is the ore of what beta? Al. Means bauxite is a most suitable mineral for the extraction of the particular metal aluminium. So upon bauxite se aluminium ko jaldi prepare kar sakte, good yield mein prepare kar sakte, on a large scale point of view we can prepare. But cryolite is not the ore of aluminium. Just cryolite is a mineral of aluminium. From bauxite and cryolite we can prepare aluminium, but bauxite is most suitable. So which is most suitable, that is called ore. Bas, next go for continue. So another definition I want to tell you here, that is nothing but gauge. Sir, what is mean by gauge? GANGEUE. Focus on words, sir. Spelling ke upar focus kijiye. Gauge. Sir, what is mean by gauge? Gauge ka main yahan par aapko aur ek meaning batana chahta, that is nothing but the matrix. Gauge, and also we can say that matrix. Sir, what is mean by Ganj? Repeated question for 1 mark. Mineral definition very important. Ore definition very important. And also Ganj ka definition be important. Right. What is mean by Ganj? So Ganj is nothing but it is a metallurgy word. Ganj in our own terminology, we have to be say that impurities. अपना लैंग्वेज में क्या बोलना इंप्यूरिटीज. व्हाट इज मीन बाय इंप्यूरिटी इन मेटलर्जी गांज. ओके ना. वन सेकेंड. सो द मिनरल्स एंड ओर्स विच आर फाउंड फ्रॉम द अर्थ क्रस्ट विच आर अवेलेबल फ्रॉम द अर्थ क्रस्ट डेफिनेटली अलॉन्ग विद दैट मिनरल्स फ्रॉम द अर्थ क्रस्ट वी विल गेट द सम सॉइल पार्टिकल्स नथिंग बट सम क्ले पार्टिकल्स एंड वी विल गेट सम सैंड पार्टिकल्स नथिंग बट रॉक्स. So soil particles and rocks which are coming from the earth crust along with the minerals and ores, such impurities are we have to be say that Ganj. Once again, minerals and ores, they are available from the, they are found from the what beta, earth crust. They are found from the earth crust. So the minerals and ores which are available, which are taken from the earth crust, definitely along with that minerals and ore, there will be some impurities. What beta? Impurities. So the impurities like one is nothing but soil and one more is nothing but sand. Soil contain clay particles and sand contain rock particles. So the soil and sand and also we can say clay and also rock, all they are nothing but the impurities, and all these impurities definitely they will be generally present along with minerals and ores. So the impurities which are present along with the minerals and ores, they are known as Ganj. Okay na. Ganj mean be fixed in our mind, impurities. So the impurities whatever that may be which are present along with the minerals and ores, they are nothing but the Ganj. Okay na beta. Good. Yes, here two questions I want to ask you. So listen carefully beta. Minerals and ores, generally they are available from the earth crust, but they goes to be found in there, some of the minerals and ores they goes to be found as in their oxide form, and some of the minerals they goes to be found in their carbonate forms, and some of the minerals and ores they goes to be found in their sulfide forms. Okay na beta. So minerals and okay ores, they can be available from the earth crust in their oxide and sulfide and carbonate and halide forms. In so many forms they will be available, but most of the metals and most of the minerals and ores, they goes to be available in the form of oxide. Jada kis form mein available hote beta? Most of the minerals and ores from the earth crust, they goes to be available in the form of oxides. So reason is why? Apne ko yahan par reason chahiye. So question puch sakte na na. Why the ores of many metals found in their oxide form? Okay? So the reason is nothing but most of the ores, they goes to be found in their oxide forms. So most of the ores, they goes to be found in their oxide form because of reason is why. Reason is I will tell you now. So aur ek point tum yahan par remember karna padega. What is the most abundant element from the earth crust? I have said that element, not metal. Most abundant element from the earth crust is oxygen. So on the basis of that concept, and also one more reason, very important, oxygen is a very reactive element, a very reactive element, and also we can say that oxygen is a most abundant element, a most abundant element from the what beta? Earth crust. Yes. So what is the most abundant element from the earth crust beta? Its most abundant element from the earth crust is oxygen, and due to its more reactivity nature, it easily combines with metals, and metals they goes to be found in their oxide forms. Samajh gaye clearly? Good. So what is the order of abundance of various types of elements from the earth crust? So I want to say that oxygen is the most abundant element, and after that is nothing but silicon, nothing but SI atom. It is also second most abundant element. Next one is nothing but aluminium, and next one is nothing but iron. Try to be focused on this later. Most abundant element is what? Oxygen. Second most abundant element is nothing but silicon. This is the order of abundance of elements, available of elements from the earth crust. Next, this is the abundance order of what elements? Now abundance elements of metals. So they will ask you the question, which is the most abundant metal from the earth crust? Aluminium. After that iron. So main yahan par do bhi tum perfectly remember karna padega. Abundance of elements from the earth crust is oxygen greater than, silicon greater than, aluminium greater than, iron. Abundance of metals from the earth crust is, in case of metals, aluminium is the first place. In case of element, oxygen will get the first place. Okay na beta? But ye question ke upar focus karna padega. Why the ores of many metals they goes to be found in their oxide form? Reason is, oxygen is a very reactive element, and it is the most abundant element. So due to these two reasons, it easily combines with metals which are more electropositive, and all the metals and most of the metals they goes to be exist and found in their what nana oxide forms. So most abundant element is oxygen. Most abundant metal is aluminium metal. Story clear? Okay na? But you have to be focused. In today's class, you have to be focused on mainly, okay, now 4 to 5 terms. One is nothing but metallurgy, one more definition mineral, one more definition ore, and one more is nothing but ganj, and abundance, okay, order of the elements, abundance order of the metals. And a question to be focused on. Okay? In tomorrow's class, we are going to discuss about the extraction of metals. Just I have written the heading. And in that topic, what are the terms going to be involved? That only we have studied today. But in tomorrow's class, pure extraction of metals in the form of chart form for different types of metals like low reactivity, moderate reactivity, high reactivity. For different types of metals, how to do the extraction of metals, I will tell you in tomorrow's class. Okay, beta? Good.